How does the soil food web suppress weeds? Weeds are a specific group of plants that grow really quickly and then immediately produce seeds. They have very short life cycles when compared to other plants. Like all plants, weeds need a lot of nitrogen in order to grow, but unlike most other plants, weeds thrive on a particular form of nitrogen called nitrates. Most other plants require some nitrates too, but they need more of a different form of nitrogen called ammonium. In a natural soil, where no fertilizers have been added, nitrogen is readily available as ammonia. Some of this is converted to nitrates by a particular group of bacteria, known as nitrifying bacteria. Scientists have discovered that nitrifying bacteria can only operate in a pH environment of 7 or above. With a balanced soil food web in place, soil pH can be prevented from reaching 7 by beneficial fungi that produce acidic compounds. And so nitrifying bacteria are prevented from converting the ammonium to nitrate. So now, ammonium is the predominant form of nitrogen available in this part of the soil. That means that weeds don't get their favorite food, and so their numbers are kept under control, making way for other plants to grow. Here's a real-world photo where you can see the difference in weed growth after just one application of soil food web biology. You can clearly see the difference. For farmers, the benefits include reduced costs and increased profits, as they no longer need to spray weed killers. For the environment, this means less toxic chemicals are being used. For humans, it means safer food. For more information about the numerous benefits of the soil food web and how you can get involved, visit soilfoodweb.com.